skills. Tricks. Richard Shore's been collecting strength equipment that spans over the course of 5 decades. He's got some really great equipment and stuff that's even older than that. There's anvils, old dumbbells, York plates, some of the stuff that really originated when strength training started to come into fashion. I've always been attracted to the history of the strength sports, and that's one of the things I love the most about the Highland Games, is there is a real history to it. And as far as history of strength, there's really not a better place than getting a chance to talk with Richard Soren. It's really where it all began. You know, 35 years ago, he started making strength equipment because no one else was. So he's gonna run us through some of it. They've got a great museum of strength and talk to us about the history of it.
We just moved to a new location and we decided, instead of having our historical pieces interwoven with our new weight equipment, we wanted to have some separate rooms so people that did want to come and study could. Here are probably the rarest barbells in the place. These came from the original Zuber's gym in Costa Mesa, California. These plates are the rarest known. They were actually just a ghost story almost, that they existed. They saw them in the back of some pictures of the gym, and where Arnold and the superstar Billy Graham and Paul Anderson
lifted.
Like
in Pumping Iron and stuff like that.
In Pumping Iron, they actually, these are the plates Arnold used. So these were only made for that gym, and these are the heaviest plates ever commercially done, 200 pounders.
I don't even know what I would do with those in my garage. They would sit there.
I saw Ed Cohn actually come up and grab them this way, and then lift them up, which was quite a feat of hand strength, but related to your sport as well.
Yeah.
In the hammer, or the heavyweight.
Yeah, they kind of lock in like that. There's a lot of strength to carry that.
These are the rarest thing. This is where the era of custom gym equipment started.
So, I mean, this is where they strength had, really began.
They had trolley started. Systems in the gym that would carry 300-pound dumbbells to Chuck Aaron's, where he would be seated pressing them. They had these only two plates in the gym set on a 600-pound bench. And the strongest men in the world, when they came in, they had to sign a register. Of course, it was the big register. Everything was big in the gym. And these two plates remained permanently on that bar. So unless you were the biggest, baddest guy on, you don't even go near that bench to touch it.
So awesome.
And all the pictures of the greats of the day, they made sure they had them with these two plates. I mean, only these two were red.
Was that like Paul Anderson days?
Anderson days, Terry Todd days. Pat Casey came and trained often. West Side, Bill West trained on Zuber plates. They had most of the West Side team started at Zuber's.
Sorinex is also going to bridge the gap between the past and the new equipment that athletes need now to maximize performance. Getting a chance to see Sorinex manufacturing facility and where they've grown to is amazing. You're talking about a 200-yard long warehouse of equipment manufacturing, powder coating, metalwork, welding, fabrication, scooters, all the stuff they keep in stock ready to ship to you whenever it's ready. Getting to train on great equipment's one thing, but none of that shit gets made by accident. Bert and them have been doing it for 35 years, so now, in their new facility, we're gonna get a chance to check out what all that entails. Let's go take a look.
This is it. Well, welcome to new Sorinex HQ.
Where this place is huge.
Oh, it's ridiculous. Yeah, I still have to pinch myself and realize that it's a pretty good rifle shot from my office to the other end. Well, like I said, the steel comes in raw form, whether it be tubular, plate steel, or solid. We'll take it over to the saw area, that'll get cut to length or whatever product it has to be, or taken over to the laser, that gets cut out, obviously CNC to perfect specifications. From there, it kind of goes through the whole chute, so let's check out whatever other we got.
Shop this big, you need scooters to get around.
All right, this is Silent Bob. He's gonna roll on some batwing chin bars for us.
Yeah,
That one gives a lot of different ergonomic handle positions for chin-ups, so that's one of the options we have on our racks.
So if you're hitting the shoulder from a bunch of different angles, as you would say.
Bunch of different angles. Science.
Get your muscles more strongest. On to the next. So, where are we at now?
Well, now we're in powder coat. It's baked on enamel finish, so we'll take it first in sandblast, rough up the finish. We have a pure bite for the paint to go into, right? We take it over there into the powder coat booth. It's sprayed on with electrostatic, so it actually sticks to the steel. From there, it goes in Dante's Inferno, the oven, cooks it at 475, bring it out with your biscuits, and you're good to go.
After powder coating, finished products?
Finished product goes onto our big assembly table. Got some more human hands on to make sure it's right. Then it goes in boxes and goes to new homes.
So about another 100 yards that way.
Scooter.
Amazing to have this much room, this much stuff in stock. Shelves like this always remind me of Raiders of the Lost Ark. Scales. Tricks. After getting an in-depth look at the process of actually making some of this equipment, I get a chance to talk with Bert about some of the changes he's seeing coming in the industry and where Sorinex is headed. You know, man, it's exciting. You and I have been friends now for way over the better half of a decade, and you know, seeing the growth you guys have seen in the last 6 or 7 years of that's been really, really amazing. You know, how has that been, and you know, how do you think the strength industry's changed, and where do you see it going?
Oh man, the strength industry is, it's becoming more fashionable. I mean, but now for a deadlift or a clean jerk or a snatch or a pull-up to not only be folks to be educated on them, but actually performing them and understand proper eating and just the healthy lifestyle. That's exciting for me as a lifelong iron gamer to go, wow, you guys are finally getting it. Yes.
And it's another thing for me too. You know, I train in a garage by myself, so I can kind of have things arrayed and not as organized, or I know what I'm going to do that day. Sure. But if you're a high-end collegiate weight room and you've got 100 athletes to run through in an hour, it's got to be ready to roll. Building equipment that can enable people to help themselves.
Yes, yeah. It's solving problems that we've seen in the weight rooms and the training facilities for years. And how do we take down some of the bottlenecks of moving athletes from one place to another, or keep them safe, or keep them accountable for their actions, and cut down the managerial time that the coach has to deal with to get the highest reward off the lowest risk, and the lowest risk of time. That's the key. So you have to be so dialed in, it's almost like a pit crew now, especially at the college level. You have to be very, very effective,
You need two people squatting on a rack at a time.
At a time, yep. Right. Yeah, just to get it in. There's no, hey, we're going to go work out today. Here's our program, has
faster
to be really
transition
tight.
Transition from a guy that's 6 foot to a guy that's 5'8".
You got it. People I know have said with you at Highland Games, you've been on the scene for about 4 years or so.
Yep.
Matt Vincent came out of nowhere. Well, no, 8 years ago we were talking about Highland Games. You were calling me, getting interested in it. We were talking, you were doing your homework, you were...
Out of nowhere, I did 3 years of strongman pretty competitively, a bunch of weightlifting, powerlifting, and then through for 10 years prior to that.
Yeah. Right. It's
overnight,
like...
Overnight success. Give this shit a go.
Sorinex, overnight success after, in 35 short years.
Exactly.
Easy enough, right?
It's people following passion, man. People into what they do, and people spending the time they have here on the planet doing shit they love. Man, I spend an awful lot of time in my garage lifting by myself that I could be out with friends having drinks, that I could, be at dinner with my wife, or I could eat shit food and do these things. Make sure you love what you're doing.
Absolutely.
Because that's where you're spending all your time. You don't get a second run at this.
Nope. And that's what I had to finally, after 20 straight years of competing, after a few injuries, I walked away from and said, I want to move forward with the next phase of my life. I want to have a wife and kids and really expand the business. But it was hard because I really loved throwing, I really loved training, I really loved that lifestyle, but the price tag was becoming too high. And people say, well, do you want to be world-class thrower again? I said, I know the price tag, and I don't have that to spend right now. And so you got to be able to walk from it.
Always awesome. Always awesome getting a check. Stoked on your new building. And it's about time to get some lunch. After getting a chance to see Sorinex's base command, we make our way to Southern Belly Barbecue for what could be now my favorite sandwich I've ever had. That says a lot.
The cool part about it is not normal South Carolina barbecue.
Good, so it's not covered in mustard.
Correct.
That stuff's terrible.
I still don't even know what this stuff is.
Why would anyone waste their time with that?
And it's awesome. It's mystery barbecue, because to this day I still don't know what meats they use.
They're piggish.
They use pork.
They're piggish chicken, but they're like mixed, and bacon is in there.
Well, that's just pig. You don't treat bacon like it's its own animal. Can we get a round of beers, or three of those?
Yeah, what kind of beer do you want?
What do you have local?
The only local ones we have are those Westbrooks, but I can bring you a beer list really fast.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Django Wookiee.
No, that's pretty fast.
That's the jam.
Awesome.
Thank you.
No problem.
Yeah, it's going to have, I believe, a chicken, a pork, some sort of bacon. If you go like a man and get the Django, it will in fact be unchained, and you'll have all types of peppers.
Oh God,
here's
would it be?
He will be unchained.
Hey, awesome. Lunchtime.
And I think we're gonna get some foods.
Awesome.
Just smoothing out. That's all it is, right?
That's it. You're a little too vascular these days.
I've been told to go Django, D is silent, and Wookiee style.
Okay, Wookiee. All right.
Yeah.
Can do that for you.
All right.
Same. That's the way to go.
Samesies.
Same
for me. I'm gonna go Southern Belly Wookiee style.
Oh, the PB and up. The PB&J.
Changes it up.
I'm
beers and barbecue. It's not a bad lunch.
It's not bad for Tuesday.
Yeah. All right, so the Django Wookiees gets pulled pork, then it gets pepper jack cheese, and then on top of that it gets two strips of bacon, jalapenos, caramelized onions, and red peppers.
So it looks so good. Oh my God. Look at that pile of wonderful. It's absolutely ridiculous. What Southern Belly failed to explain was Wookiee means you just double it. You just basically take the original sandwich, and you take another one, and you jam them together with one piece of bread between them instead of two. Saves the carbs.
That's Django Wookiee. That's what I'm needing.
All right, we got some Wookiee-sized Django.
Wookiee that Jang.
There we go.
What up?
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's a knife and forker.
Yeah, as I say, eat it with a...
Come
on, dude.
We might need some nappies. How's that for your war on carbs, Matt?
All right, it's going to take a truce today. You're going to take a back seat to being awesome. Look, some days when you're just in the truck, it's not worth pounding cheeseburgers by yourself, but if you get to eat somewhere awesome with awesome people, you fucking let go.
That's right. It.
So, lunch is done, on to the next thing. We're gonna go shoot some guns, as you should do in the South. New episodes every 2 weeks. Also, click subscribe, like, and go to thehate.com, new stuff. Maybe get some hats for your sledgehammer. Get right.